Hi everyone, my name is Paris. Welcome to my page. And today I am going to be discussing how it's been training to become a naturopathic doctor. I am on week 3 of the program, and I really just want to show you guys what the campus looked like, what the vibe of Seattle is like, and just rules and regulations of what to expect in general going into this program and going to the school, because I felt like there was a lack of genuine knowledge. So I came kind of blindsided, but it wasn't a bad experience at all. I just wish that someone would have put information out there for me to see. So let's get started. So this is pretty much just footage of Seattle. And let me be clear, Bastyr is in Kenmore, which is 45 minutes away. So don't get confused when you are driving mad far from the city, because Kenmore is the location, not Seattle itself. And if you are a person who enjoys being downtown or near food places and shopping complexes, I just want to let you know, going to the school, you're going to have to travel further than what you're used to go do things. A lot of the places are different on the West Coast than it is on the East Coast where I'm from. And also, the access sucks. So everything I like to do is always 35 to 40 minutes away, like the mall or certain stores, Walmarts. It's ridiculous. Also, please enjoy this commentary from my parents. It's funny.
Seattle campus. Oh, where's the light? Where's the light? This look like that shit you wanted to live in, Joe and Grand Rapids.
I'm talking about me, but I ain't talking about you. Me, I'm fine. I got plenty of guns and shit. This don't
bother. Don't be riding this shit at night, man.
Yeah. What? Joe, move your arm.
You seen this shit already?
I'm filming for a YouTube video. So, as you can see, they are hilarious, but yes, this school is pretty much in the middle of the woods, and they did say that on the website that you will be living in a forest. So, I'm not going to say it's the worst thing in the world, but just be prepared for that. It's a different culture and nothing crazy happens out here. It's really pretty, actually. And there's a lake that's not far, but yeah, it's different.
Stop. Permit parking. Okay, we're going to stop.
Really? So this is where everyone lives, and you can choose whether you want to live on campus or not, but to be honest, it's so convenient, and I actually really enjoyed moving into my dorm because it was clean and quiet, so I wouldn't say the living conditions are bad at all. I think it's a great option if you're coming from out of town. And this is my room. This is the last thing I wanted to show you guys that I filmed, and you do get your own bathroom.
Okay, so that was pretty much all of the footage that I filmed. There are other videos online of how the kitchen looks and how the rest of the dorm looks. I don't think that I needed to include it because this is a home and there's people's things here. So what I'm going to do is talk about the living here, the living conditions, because there are a lot of rules. And if you are a person that enjoys
Well, let's just go over it, okay? It's different. So, one rule that was very alarming to me was that there is no scent, like smells at all. So they want you to have unscented soap, unscented deodorant, unscented laundry detergent, and it has to be laundry detergent with HE on it, I believe. What else? Just everything that you put on yourself and you omit into the air, whether it's soap or cleaning supplies, it should not have a smell. And that is mostly because they have a belief that those chemical smells harms the environment and it has harm on yourself. And these things are true. However, if you are a person who enjoys smelling good, like, you know, wearing your perfume, well, you just can't wear perfume on this campus, period, because that's just not what this campus is about. You have to come with no smell. But as far as your home life, if you like candles, if you like essential oil diffusers and all of those things, you cannot, just plain and simple. And it sounds harsh, but you get used to it. It's not jail, it's not horrible. I had to find Dove soap that was unscented, and I had to switch my dish detergent. My laundry detergent was the same. I still use all. It's just, none of the stuff has a smell to it, and that's okay, because now I've gotten used to it. And I've gotten used to, like, not smelling florally under my arms. It just smells like nothing. Everything smells like nothing. Yeah, it is what it is. Another thing is that everything stays super duper clean. You have chores in the hall. At least my hall does. So you can sign up for like the week or the 3 weeks that you want to have chores for the semester. And pretty much they make you take the trash out for the hall and sweep, mop, all of those things, because they keep it super duper clean. I really like that, because when I was an undergrad, you know how it is in undergrad, nobody care, people just leaving dishes and there's no real roommate agreements. It becomes a hot mess. But here, you have to clean up after yourself. You cannot leave any dishes. You must either put it in the dishwasher or wash it, dry it, and put it back where it belongs. And you need to wipe the counters off. Make sure it looks like you were never even there after you cook. And to me, I liked it. I like that it holds me accountable and it prevents a lot of altercation with other people. Also, there is quiet time between the hours of 10 p.m. and 8 a.m., meaning that there should not be any loud talking, music. If you are washing clothes, they will stop your clothes at 10 p.m. no matter what cycle it's on. And it's not personal, it's just community rules to keep everybody in alignment with each other. And actually, I really love it. I love it. I thought it was a lot at first, but then once I started living here, everything became easy and it flowed. So that's all I'm going to say about the living conditions. It's something that you can definitely do. It's in your reach. I'm doing it, and you see how dramatic I am. Just imagine all the smells, like the frankincense and the perfumes and the lotions. But I had to get over that, you know, it is what it is. So moving on to the next point of business, class. So like I said, I'm on week 3 and I've already had 3 tests. And naturopathic medical school, the first 2 years or the first year mimics regular medical school. So, or not regular, let's call it allopathic. It mimics allopathic medical school a lot. So don't come here thinking you chose the easier route just because you didn't have to take the MCAT or whatever the case may be. That does not matter because the material is a lot and it takes organization just like anything else. So it's either you're committed to doing this type of work or you're not. So I recommend that you know when you get here what you want to do and that you're passionate about it, because this work is enough to just make you second guess yourself. Also, a lot of people were surprised to know that in naturopathic medical school, even though we aren't doing surgeries per se, like major surgeries, you still need a cadaver. And a cadaver is a donated human body that you are practicing on and you eventually give back to their families for cremation. And that, I think, freaked a lot of people out. So I just want to let you guys know that up front, no surprises. You will be working as if you're going to allopathic medical school. Like, there's no way around it. You're going to have to deal with the bodies, and the professors are amazing. They're very passionate. So if you're passionate, there shouldn't be a problem with grasping and understanding the material. But you have to read and you have to show up. So that's that. I think on the naturopathic side, like outside of the sciences, because the sciences are really dense and heavy, but outside of the sciences, we do like constitutional assessment, therapeutic alliance, naturopathic theories, and these are classes in your first year. I think, I don't know what other years you have to do these classes, but they kind of ground you into the thought process of what is naturopathic medicine, how to be mindful and work on your communication skills, work on yourself. And I think that's where you see change and growth outside of knowledge, like science textbook wise. You have the opportunity to grow by just coming to class and communicating your ideas and your standpoint, which is very important to me, because coming from a place of studying African traditional religions and medicines, it's important that my ideas are recognized and brought to surface. So they definitely give you a lot of space to talk about the things that you need to talk about. And it's awesome. I love it because I've never had that type of growing space before. So yeah, I think that's all the material I want to talk about today. If you guys have any more questions, please put them in the comments, because I mean, I kind of rushed through this video, but I just want to give you guys like a brief summary of everything I've been going through and what the campus looked like, the rules. Later on, I will get more into detail about other things. There's so much to talk about, but I need material for our next video. So like I said, give me some ideas, and thank you for coming here to my video. I hope that you've learned something and you have a better perspective on what to expect in when you get here. Yeah. I'm going to insert a video of my mother crying and going viral on TikTok. But anyway.
Saying goodbye to parents after moving across the country.
I'll send you pictures. You don't need a picture of the room.